Hey, welcome. We're here at Pebblepalooza number 6 in Dallas, Texas. I'm here with my friend Mike Powers, and we're going to talk a little to Brother John Hammond.
Indeed. Good to see you, Trudy.
Yes, sir. It's been a while. It has been a while, huh?
Good.
So we have this Facebook page devoted, it's a group devoted to Brother John and his work, and also some of his memories that people can share. What memories do you have of Brother John?
This sounds like a really great project to do, because this guy may be underrated, you know, we know, but maybe he's not as well known as he should be.
Mm-hmm.
And, but yeah, we were talking earlier, and I told Trini a story about a John Mendoza convention in the 80s. John used to put on these conventions every year or so. I mean, one year he had Mike Amar, Klaus, Daryl, and Derek Dingell at one convention.
It's quite a lineup.
Totally close up. But the year that I really remember was when Brother John was the featured lecturer. And I had the Lebal book, and this is way before the Hammond book came out.
Mm-hmm.
But I had that, so I had kind of some knowledge that this guy does some interesting stuff, and so we definitely wanted to see his show. But the standout moment, and this is one of those moments in, you know, your entire magic life that you just go, that's one of those ones that's at the top three of every, of just how cool that moment was in magic, and it involved Brother John. So he's doing a lecture, and he had done a bunch of stuff, the Marx Brothers and all kinds of stuff, and just really cool plots. And he gets to what we now know as the signed card.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, the signed card. So one of the great tricks that he ever came up with. But this was totally unknown. So, you know, there's a small group of probably about 50 people, and he goes into the signed card, and nobody's seen it. So you have to remember unknown trick. And he comes up, and then the selection is, and Don Englund was sitting right next to me, and we just kind of went, you know, I wanted to check his face out. Is he got blown away as bad as I did? Because sometimes we wonder, you know, did everybody get it except me? No, nobody had any idea how this trick worked. And it was just an extraordinary moment. And so we're just like stunned how cool this trick is and have no idea. And so Brother John goes into the explanation of the trick, which is a simple explanation, really. It's not a complicated trick, sleight of hand-wise.
Mm-hmm.
And so we had this trick for ourselves for about a year before it got published. I think it was published in Richard's Almanac. So it was really cool to lay this on your pals that who also had never seen it and weren't going to hear about it or find it anywhere except, you know, one of those moments. Hey, Trini, let me show you a trick. And you're like, whoa. You know? So that was memorable. So I've had a few experiences that jump out as real mind-blowing moments in magic, and that was my Brother John experience.
Oh, nice. That's awesome. Well, Mike, thank you very much.
Indeed.
I appreciate you sharing that story.
Good to see you, man.
Yes,
sir. Good luck with the website, and I know you told me that you have some interesting stuff to kind of unleash along the way that people should be looking forward to, because it's going to be really cool.
Definitely. Correct. Well, thanks, guys, and join us next time. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.